members. Thank you to all the people that have come into our life. We've had some unbelievable mentors, and we just want to thank our senior vice presidents, Mindy and Jeremy Diebel, our regional vice president, Mrs. Karen Dorfline, the entire Kahane family, Spencer, Martha, Jim, Megan, and Ryan. We just love all of you. All of these leaders, I mean, they've honestly touched our lives in so many ways. So many people that we just don't even know personally, but in our team. So many people rallied to get us here. And we're just thankful and we're proud. You know, 3.5 years ago, just over 3.5 years ago, when someone invited me to hear a presentation, I was thankful that we weren't prejudged. And here's why. On the outside, everything still looks really good. But on the inside, we were at a place of prayer. See, in 2002, when Todd retired with the Arizona Diamondbacks, we had time when we had money together. We got to do what we wanted, when we wanted, with who we wanted, with no financial handcuffs, no financial stress. I got to enjoy being a stay-at-home mom to our 4 incredible children. Todd worked because he wanted to. But in 2008, 2009, something happened. See, when the recession hit, we were not shielded. And we started to lose money. We lost businesses overnight, companies that we invested in a lot of money and were no longer companies. The stock market, the real estate market, it didn't play favorites, okay? It was like quicksand. But here's what else we lost. Our time. See, Todd started working around the clock. He was trying to hang on to companies we'd invested in. I felt like I had lost my husband. The kids felt like they had lost their father. And when he was home, he really wasn't even home. See, there were many times during that time that I woke up in the middle of the night and he wasn't in bed next to me because he was in his office or he was pacing the halls, and I thought he was going to have a heart attack. See, I wanted to do something. I wanted to contribute, and I felt defeated. I didn't know what I could do. And I said we were at a place of prayer. Todd and I were actually praying for a business, or for something that we could buy that wasn't going to take a big investment, that could kick out cash flow right away. Within 1 week, we were shown ACN. God is good. And I saw that presentation. I saw the DVD and the lifestyle. I saw the money on that sheet, and I thought to myself, if people are really doing this, and this kind of money can be created, I knew we could do it too. I just had to convince my husband. So I came home, I was super excited. I said, honey, I found a business. He gave me a talk to the hand. He said, I'm businessed out. I don't have time for the businesses I'm doing. I don't have time for my family. I don't have time. I said, okay, give me 1 hour. He said, okay, at the end of the hour, I'm gonna be in the car. If you're not sitting next to me, you're gonna find a different ride home. He said, okay. So I got him in front of the information. He got excited like I did. 3 days later, we ended up in Anaheim at an international event as guests. And this is where I'm gonna have Todd take our story, but this is the last thing I wanna say. See, when I met my husband, he was already a Major League Baseball player. I didn't, nor did our children, get to see how hard he worked and what it took for him to get there and achieve at that level. But because of ACN and because of everything that we've gone through, we had an opportunity to see what a true champion he is and what an inspiration he's been to our family and so many people.
My father was a pitcher for the New York Yankees. my mentor, my coach, my best friend. I had a great inspiration. I had a dream that started when I was about two, just out of diapers. And that dream was to play Major League Baseball and follow in my father's steps. And then to actually grow up, to live out a dream, to live that dream out, to play 15 years, to land on three world championship teams, just tells you that in my life, I've been in the right place, the right time on several occasions. You know, but over the span of that 15 years, like Erica said, you know, we amassed millions. And I mean lots of millions. But when we went into 2008, everything that I had dreamed for, worked for, and accomplished in Major League Baseball, we were watching go up in smoke, and it was a domino effect we couldn't stop. And like Erica said, it was one of those situations where we just began working around the clock. So coming to that first national convention back in 2009 was an unbelievable experience. So it went like this. First of all, we showed up at 8:45. We had no idea people had waited 4 hours in line to get a seat. So we showed up at 8:45 back in Anaheim at the convention center, and I remember pulling those doors open. And I remember that there was music going on, there was a light show, there were people waving flags and banners and clanking things together. And as we took 10 steps into the convention center, as a guest, it came to a dead stop, and I said to Erica, thank God we came here, because there is no way I'm going to become one of those people. But the guy who invited us and we were a guest of is a dear friend, and he's a tall, distinguished man, and he was had a seat that he had saved for us, and I could see him all the way down the row, way up front, waving his arms. And the only thing I could think is, I said, yeah, I see you, big guy. Can't wait to get up there. And I told Eric, I said, here's what we're going to do. 1 hour. Back to the 1 hour. 1 hour, I'm going to excuse myself, use the restroom, follow me 5 minutes later, we're going to Disneyland. And then Mr. Provenzano took the stage right at 9:00. And I gotta tell you, as I sat there and as I watched and I witnessed, I could see the sweat off his brow, and it spelled integrity, moral, ethics, vision, excellence. And I thought, oh my goodness. And then we watched promotions on that Saturday, and I'll never forget this lady who was carried to the stage, who I don't even know by name today, and as I listened to her story, I had massive reflection. When she talked about cancer and some different things, and I was like, wow, I felt that, but I also listened to her about overcoming. And then they announced the Ronald McDonald House Charities. And you see, I'm a Ronald McDonald House family. And back in 1981, the state of the Ronald McDonald House, after giving my little brother a bone marrow transplant where he was fighting for his life at the age of 11, was diagnosed with leukemia for the third time. The bone marrow transplant appeared to work, but put him into a coma. He never seen daylight again outside of the hospital, but he taught me two valuable lessons. I was 15 at the time. Number one, he taught me how to live. Number two, he taught me how to die. You see, those lessons was dream, believe, fight, until the last breath, and never give up on what you believe in. head down and said, what in the world is God doing to us now? See, because at that moment, we were becoming everything at 8:45 I didn't want to become. Today I'm wearing team colors, I'm proud of them. Today I wave a flag. And I'm proud. See, my life changed and transformed during that period of time. See, back in 2009, towards the end of that day, it was like the ceiling had opened up and a light shining down, and I heard words from above, welcome home. And I know that the first 45 years of my life was nothing more than a dress rehearsal for where exactly where I'm supposed to be. Children, you don't see them, but I see them. Our four children are with us today. Our four children get on every single plane, in every rental car, they stay in every home, they sleep on every couch with me on the road. There was a day where we traveled and vacationed where I was digging sandcastles, and I can tell you that to lose that time, and for them, for a short period of time, to lose their father, here's what I'm most proud of as I stand in front of you today. My son is 8, has a dream of playing Major League Baseball, but also says he's going to do ACN when he's not playing baseball. My 10-year-old says he's going to absolutely do ACN and maybe take care of some pets. My 12-year-old is going to rule Hollywood and do ACN on the side. My 17-year-old wants to go to medical school while she's pursuing her dreams with ACN, and I couldn't be more proud. Let me ask you all something today in closing. Did you come home?
Yes!
So stand with me if you came home real quick. And let's change the world one person at a time. God bless all of us.